Hey, how's it going, everyone? It's Adamil here, and today I'm going to be bringing you another Dissidia Final Fantasy Opera Omnia video. In this video, we're going to be tackling the three newest lost chapters, which is going to be Faris, Prish, and Ramza on their hard mode quest level 90. And we're going to be using our monk team, which is going to be Yda, Prish, and Snow. Hopefully these battles won't be too hard because the power creep has risen a lot in these couple of events, you know, such as Aiko and Sazh. You know, they've been really good with, providing damage, providing support, and just kind of making content a lot easier. And unfortunately, my three little monks here are pretty old. You know, like their weapons are pretty old, so power creep has risen a little bit, so it is harder to do events with just these three characters. So I can't wait for having new monks to play with. Now, as you can see, I'll be adding timestamps on the side here on the video. So if there's any chapter, a lost chapter that you want to skip to, or you just want to see a specific one, you can just click on the timestamp, which is going to be included in the description and also on screen next to the video. Hopefully you guys enjoy this type of content. I'll be trying to provide more, making more videos. It has been a bit tough because I am still learning Photoshop and all that, but anyways, make sure to subscribe and give this video a like for more content, and I'll try my best to provide more videos for you guys. So I hope you guys enjoy. Alright guys. Hey guys, so we're going to be doing Prish's Lost Chapter, the level 90 hard mode quest with our monk team, which is going to be Yda, Prish, and Snow. Our summon of choice is going to be Ifrit because the final boss will have a form, which is his goat form, that's going to be weak to fire. Let's see, I think we're going to be choosing Aiko for our friend summon because she can provide a little bit of healing in case we take some damage with the adds. So let's see, so the most important thing now is going to be reducing as much damage as possible because we don't want, because our team lacks any form of support or healing. So we would want to reduce as much damage as possible. Alright, now let's see who I can... Okay, they all attack Yda, so I can actually start focusing on one of the enemies. I'm gonna use the skeleton. Oh, I can actually one-shot the bomb. Alright, let's do that. I'm gonna... Oh, a little bit. I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna use it. Finish out a little bit of damage. Yep, finish him off without taking any HP damage. Got three skeletons. Will I be able to? No, I don't think an HP attack would finish him off. Go with...
Come on,
use. Because I'm not sure how bad the final boss will be. And the Golem Chimera. So I'm gonna save as much abilities as possible. And just do our standard Brave and HP attack. So if there's a launch, usually I'll do a HP attack just because when they bounce off like that, it adds HP damage to your total. So I try to get as much damage as possible. And we have 3 turns. I'm gonna break. Oh, just a little bit. Let's see, I should... Yeah, I'm gonna... Yeah, go for it. And then I'm gonna actually use... Again, her buff going. And speed jump up. So for the summon, I'm actually going to wait until he transforms into his goat form for the second time. Because it's kind of like, I'm going to use the summon emergency, Brave Break. Okay, so he turned into his lion form. And he still has Aiko too. For backup. I'm gonna use a frostbite. Shave is brave. So he starts doing his permanent buffs. Alright, so a bit of HP damage there. And that's his dragon form. So definitely Prish is doing work because it is her event as well. She does have synergy. I'm gonna Steelguard one more time. So that's why, you know, she's doing so much damage. Now I'm gonna try to prevent, because if I did an HP attack there, I was gonna get broken. Okay, so now is his second code form. Should have been a launch. Attacked him there. Actually, I'm going to. Let's see, I have four turns. I'm gonna summon Echo and summon Ifrit. I'm gonna provide a buff to this move, and then hopefully I can dish out as much damage as possible. Five, 7 turns. That's a huge chunk of damage. I'm gonna use Snap Punch again. And there's the speed up. Now, if I remember correctly, this buff can't be dispelled, but it can be stolen with Balthier. And then we'll be again. And then Aiko's gonna be gone, so I will HP. Maybe he'll do a HP attack. Maybe that was the wrong move for her to get broken. Let's see. Well, Prish does so much damage that it doesn't really. Yeah. Even with him with 8,000, it's back to zero.
Yep.
Oh man, I wanted to HP attack, but he has a lightning flash. Or sand. So let's see, I'm going to. HP. Won't finish him off quite yet, but I. Let's see, if I go all out, maybe. Do some damage. And then maybe HP attack? Yep, so we just completed Prish's Lost Chapter, the hardest battle. With our monk only team. Do we get full clear? Yes, we do. Nice, alright.
Hut! Hot! Hineryon! Thank you. やるぜ!
ひねりよっ!